Hi everyone and welcome to the Industry Automation channel. I'm Navid and in this video we will talk about the data types in TIA Portal. Today we will learn some basic data types in TIA Portal like byte, integer, real, etc. What's the difference and how to use them in our program. Data type means the format of the variable or constant used in a program. The first data type is Boolean or bit. Boolean can be only true or false, or in other words, 1 or 0. Let's see this data type in TIA Portal. Open the PLC tags and then click on Show All Tags. Here we can create and see all our variables, their data type and the tags that we have defined for them. Write a name for the variable. This variable will be created in the default tag table. You can add more tag tables with add new tag table and then select it here. Boolean can be used to represent whether an input is activated or not. So let's go to the main OB and insert the button. When the button is pressed, it will be considered 1, and if it's released, it will be 0. It can be also used for an output, whether it is on or off. Let me create another Boolean. So we use I0.0, Q0.0 or M0.0. If you remember, M indicates memory. All the variables can sit in the input, outputs or memory. The first number refers to the byte number and the second number determines the bit number, which can be 0 to 7. Simulate the program. Click on the glass icon to monitor the variables. As you see, the input button is not activated and it's false. Now both the input and output are 1 or true. The next data type is byte, which takes 8 bits and its range can be -128 to 127 for signed or 0 to 255 for unsigned values. Signed means that the range has both positive and negative values. Unsigned means the range has only positive values. If your variable is in this range, you can use byte. We show the byte variable with MB. For example, let's use an AND logic operation between two bytes. I'm going to define two more byte variables. Simulate the program. Let's define the first byte 30. As you know, 30 is 110 in binary format. And the second one, 5, which is 101. As you see, the result will be 1. But what happens if we define here -129 for signed value or 256 for unsigned value? You see, TIA portal says the modified value is out of the range of byte. Short integer and unsigned short integer are similar to byte. They have also a length of 8 bits and both are represented by MB. In other words, an operand of data types short integer or unsigned short integer occupies 1 byte in the memory. Short integer consists of two components, a signed and a numerical value. The signal state of bit 0 to 6 represent the number value, and the signal state of the bit 7 represent the sign. 0 for the positive and 1 for the negative signal state. For example, the following figure shows the integer value for plus 44. I'm going to define these variables in TIA. Insert an add operation and define another variable for short integer. Download the chains. Modify the values with your desired numbers inside the valid range. That's it. As you see, we used two short integer and one unsigned short integer with an add operation. Just be very careful to consider the valid range to short integer and unsigned short integer. For example, I modify for short integer 129. But as you see, we have here -127. In this case, an overflow will happen and the result won't be correct. The next one is word, which is 2 bytes or 16 bits. MW represents a word of PLC memory. For example, mWord 6 includes mByte 6 and 7. To get a better understanding of the space used by data types, you can right-click on the PLC and go to the assignment list. This list will show you which bits are used by which variables. As you see in our program, byte 0 is used by the variable byte 1, or unsigned short integer uses the whole byte number 4. Just remember, you can see the variables here that you have used in the program. We have defined the mVert 6, but we have not used it in the main OP, so you don't see it here. Let me use it in our add function. Now we can see that 2 bytes 6 and 7 of the memory are used by the variable word. On the right side, you can also see the inputs and outputs of a PLC that we have used in the program. Then we have integer and unsigned integer, which like a word takes 16 bits of memory and are represented with MW. Integer is used for signed values and in this range, and unsigned integer for positive values in this range. Now double word, which is two words, and we show it with MD. It takes 4 bytes in PLC memory. So the variable double word 12 takes the bytes 12 to 15. And next is double integer and unsigned double integer. They have also 32 bits length and are represented with MD. Operands of the data type real have a length of 32 bits and are used to represent floating point numbers like 2.4 or -7.2. Operands of the data type long real have a length of 64 bits and are also used to represent floating point numbers with a wider range. Let's insert a comparison operation to compare two real numbers. I add another real variables. I'm going to define them with float numbers. In this way, we can use two real variables in our program. Let's talk about character. We have two different character types in TIAPortal, character and void character. Character uses one byte in the ASCII format, but void character has a length of a word in a Unicode format. As you see, we have used already the byte zeros, so we need to use another address of the memory. Next, we have time. It includes data type time and long time. The representation contains information for days, hours, minutes, seconds, and milliseconds. Long time can also show the time in nanoseconds and uses 64 bits. Alright, the next is the date data type saves the date as an unsigned integer. The representation contains the year, month, and the day. Data type TOD or time of the day occupies a double word and stores the number of milliseconds since the beginning of the day as an unsigned integer. We will learn the functions of the time and date in another video. Okay, these are some important data types that we use in TIAPortal, especially with the math operations, that I will talk about them in the next video. If you need more and detailed information about the data type, you can use the TIAPortal help. Some other data types, such as user-defined data types, UDT, array or structure, we will also learn in a separate video. In the end, I hope this video was helpful for you. If you have any question, please don't hesitate to write it in the comments. See you next video.